Canvas app is not responsive by design, and we have to choose the screen type when we creating Canvas app. So in this demo, we will learn how to make a responsive Canvas app. We will follow these outlines, understanding the properties that control the layout. Create responsive Canvas app by editing the app properties, control alignment, and responsive font size. Before we begin, we have to know some important characteristics that we will take in consideration while developing a responsive Canvas app. The first thing that we have to know is how to detect device types. First, we have to know that PowerApps provides out-of-the-box size breakpoints, and the screen size property is calculated by comparing the screen's width property to the values in the app's size breakpoints property. The size breakpoints can be 600, 900, and 1200, or it can be 1200, 1800, or 2400, which represent mobile, tablet, and web, beside extra large device. You can customize these breakpoints for your app by changing the value of its size breakpoints property, or you can use more than 3, or you can have 2 size breakpoints if you want. We have to know that the device can be small, medium, large, and extra large, and they are related to the size breakpoints that we just mentioned. Before we beginning our responsive layout, we must have a good knowledge about these 4 properties for the screen and any control you need to make it responsive. These properties are height, the distance that the item take in the y-axis, and the width property that represents the distance that the item take in x-axis, and x position, the position of the item in x-axis. It begins with 0 from the left of the app and increasing while going to the right. And the last property, y position, the position of the item in y-axis. It begins with 0 from the top of the app. Now we will start our demo for creating responsive Canvas app. I will create a blank Canvas app and try to apply responsive feature to this app. First, before choosing the format, keep in mind the format we are going to choose will be the minimum screen size for the app. There are 2 formats, tablet and phone format. So, although we are building responsive app, a minimum screen size must be set when choosing the format. If we choose tablet format, then the minimum screen size that will appear is for tablet, and we still use it in phone, but we will find scrolls. So, when I need to make responsive app, I prefer to choose the minimum screen size, the phone format, and make it responsive for the other screen size. The app name, responsive app, create. This is a blank Canvas app. First, I will give the app background color or image, or even give a theme to the app to enable us to see the changes that will happen. You can choose the fill property and fill with color, or you can write your color here in the fill property, sky blue. First, I will save the app. Control S or from file, save to the cloud, responsive app, and save. I will see my created app in your apps, responsive app. We didn't do anything yet in responsive. this is my blank screen. Okay, return it back to my app. Now I will apply the responsive feature to the canvas app. The first thing that we want to make the screen take the size of the device I use. Then from my canvas app file, from the setting, screen size and orientation, the first thing to do is to make the scale to fit off and the look orientation off. If we keep the look orientation property on, the app screen will not rotate even if the user rotates his device. It will keep its original orientation, that is portrait. So we will turn off the look orientation in order to enable the app screen to change its orientation when the user rotates his device. Don't forget to apply your settings by pressing this button, apply button. I will refresh the app now to show the responsive feature. I forget to save and publish this version to see the responsive feature that I made. As you see, the screen of the app takes all my device screen. This is the first step for building responsive canvas app. Now let's insert some controls to apply responsive layout for them. I will insert a label. Insert a label. This label. Responsive app. Center. Okay. I will give a width to this label to fill the app width. I will give it maximum of app dot width or app dot design width. Okay. Do a color, the X position, Y. As we said that the Y position start from zero, from the top of the app. Return back to the width. Before we continue, I want to discuss the difference between app.width and app.design width. The app.width is the width of the screen the user use, and the app.design width is the design width that we choose for the app. Before we continue, let's insert two labels to show the difference between app.width and app.design width. Insert label and label. Okay. This 2, this 4, app width. I will give it a formula to return the app dot width. Okay, and this design width. Return app.design width. Okay. The 2 now is 640. This is the size of the actual app that I have. I will save and make sure publish this version. Okay. As you see, the app width change it, but the design width still the same. As I said that the app width is the width of the device that the user use. Let's minimize and see As you see, the app width changed, but the design width still the same. Okay. So, if I minimize, this is the difference between app width and design width. Another responsive feature that I will do now is the font size. I will make a responsive font for this label that change according to the screen size that the user use. As we said that the screen size is small, medium, large and extra large, so you can set the size property. Search for the size. Okay. Changes to be. I can switch between the screen types. Parent to size. If the screen size dot small, then make the font size 18. And if the screen size medium, make the font size, for example, 25. Another screen type, screen size dot large. The font size will be, for example, 35. And the last screen size is extra large. You can set a number and close the formula, or you can write screen size extra large, make the font size 45. This is the formula for the font size. Save and publish to see. This is the changes. I will refresh the app. If I minimize, notice the font size now small. If I increase the screen size, the font size increased. If I increase more, the font size increased more. And for this screen, the font is increased. So this is the formula for make the font responsive according to the screen size that the user use. You can apply this formula for what controls you need with your own font size, and you can make a variable for this formula and use in the font size instead of writing the whole formula. Now let's do another responsive feature. Let's align a control to a specific position. For example, I will insert an image and want to align it to the center of the app. From the media, insert image. Okay. Add an image file. Open. To centralize this image, you have to take in consideration that the center point of the control will be the center of the app width. So the formula will be half of the app width minus half of this image dot width to get the center of the control. So the formula will be for the x position will be app dot width minus this control image dot width image to dot width. We'll divide all by 2. We will take the half of this formula to put the control to the center, or we can do app.width over 2 minus image2.width over 2. The two are the same and will work. So it's centralized to the app design. Save the app and publish to see. Refresh. Okay. If I minimize, the X position of the image control is centralized to the app according to the screen size that I have. If I increase, it will be in the center. Okay. Back to our canvas app. From that, we can conclude that to align any control, we have to be aware of the X and Y positions and calculate the formula to the alignment position that we need, and you can do that for any properties that you want to make it responsive to your screen size. For example, let's increase the size of the image by a ratio according to the app width that the user will use. This image approximately take half of this app, so I will increase the size, the width of this image to be half of the app width. I will increase the height also if you need it for any ratio that you want. For example, app.width over to make it a square. Save and publish. If I don't save and publish, I don't see the changes that I do. Let's refresh the app. Okay, as you see, it takes half of the app. If I decrease the screen size, the image will decrease. If I increase the image, both width and height increases. You can apply any responsive layout for the controls that you need. Only you have to think about any responsive features that you want and try to represent this thinking in formula. This is what will we cover for this video, and we will see other features during the app demos that we will have